Hey guys, we are in the basement. Today we're gonna do a John's Arcade on the road. That is right, guys, and guess what? We're actually going back to California. Yeah, we really are. And you know what? I know. I'm traveling too much, guys. But I went to visit my friend Craig out in California, and he's also an arcade collector. And so we were hanging out, and we went and did some arcadey stuff. And actually, it just so happens that prior to me going out there, do you guys remember the Vintage Arcade Superstore? Do you remember that? We went there, that Gene Lewin arcade. Well, I guess he has another warehouse. And the guy that manages it, I guess Royce and Jordan too, they contacted me and they said, hey, John, you know, Gene failed to mention that he had another warehouse, and next time you're out here in California, stop on by and check it out. So in this video, we're gonna do that. The place, I think, is technically called Royce's Arcade Warehouse, and it's basically an overstock warehouse that Gene Lewin owns, and it's in Chatsworth, California. I don't know, I'm not familiar with the area. So anyway, in this video, we're gonna go to California and we're gonna go check out this warehouse. It's actually kind of cool because there's basically two parts in this warehouse. The one part is set up so people can play the games, like a showroom. And yeah, they sell the games here. And on Saturdays, they open up the showroom to the public for free, and all the games are on free play, and whoever wants to come can come and play these games. And he says he gets like a couple hundred people to show up every Saturday, so pretty crazy. And then in the back of the warehouse is where the good stuff is, and we're gonna explore in there, and there's some actually pretty rare stuff in this warehouse, so it's pretty cool. So anyway, enough of that, let's get in the car, and by the way, we're gonna go to California, come back, and then we're gonna do viewer mail. So anyway, let's get in the car and let's take a ride to Royce's Arcade Warehouse in Chatsworth, California. All right, guys, we are in, where are we, Chatham, Chatsworth, Chatsworth, is it Chatsworth?
Yes.
With a T?
Chatsworth.
Chatsworth.
Yes.
Like worthy of chatting.
Yes.
Okay. And we're at Arcade Warehouse here, and, you know, this is actually, you guys remember, we went to Gene's Warehouse, Vintage Arcade Superstore, is that what that was?
In Glendale.
So this is Gene's other warehouse. So let's go see what's going on in here. And I guess this place is open to the public on Saturdays. You can come here and play some games. So what's up, guys?
Good
job. So
welcome to the Arcade Warehouse.
And you're Royce?
I'm Royce.
And
Jordan.
And Jordan. So you guys work for Gene. This is Gene's warehouse, right?
This is the Vintage Arcade outlet, essentially.
His outlet. It's yes. Like his outlet store?
Yes.
Like seconds are here?
Everything you see here, we sell as is off the showroom floor.
Oh, is that right?
We can do full restores just like Gene does.
Yeah.
But this is basically all his overstock.
It is. It's overstock. And then on the weekends, people can come here and play the games for free. Just hang out.
Correct. Every Saturday, 9 to 4, you can come into the shop. Everything's on free play.
Oh, nice.
No heavy sales.
So do you get a good turnout? People show up all the time?
Somewhere between 100 to 200 people every Saturday.
Get out of here. 100 to 200 people?
Every Saturday. And we've only been doing it about 5.5 months.
Really?
Yeah.
And is there like beverages and beer and stuff?
We actually have a candy counter over here.
Oh, really?
We converted a lethal enforcers.
You did?
To a candy counter.
Oh, that's funny. Oh, that's so, that's a great idea. Wow, that's actually well done. I like that. That's awesome.
So yeah, so everything you see is for sale. We've got games starting at about $800 and up. We have a $100 a month rental package we do, like Netflix.
Yeah.
Where we'll bring you a game, local delivery, and we'll trade you a new arcade every month.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Oh, that's cool. So you could pay $100 a month and you have a game in your house.
Correct.
And you get bored of it and you'll swap it out for another one.
If you get sick of Street Fighter, we'll bring you Pac-Man.
Oh, that's cool. Yeah. Yeah. Well, let's walk around. Let's see what's going on in here. So, all right, so Monaco GP, this is like the cocktail version. That's a Sega game. And that's got a price tag $800 on it. That's reasonable for at a retail setting.
Right off the floor, ready to roll.
And you got some pins here. Pinbot, Judge Dredd, which I think is a really cool pin.
All the pins get serviced by Gene's guys over in Glendale.
Okay. Then you got some EM stuff here. Gottlieb King Rock, $6 Million Man, a Williams Road Kings. A little Neo Geo. These are cool. I guess, would you call it a cabaret or a mini?
I think it's a cabaret. It's more in line with like the Monaco.
And if you could see, what's interesting about this, though, like my buddy Jay got one of those, and he was all excited because he's collecting cabarets. And he's like, but it's like for a little kid. I mean, you can't, like an adult can't comfortably play this at all.
No. Luckily, we have a family of Neo Geos in the back.
Oh, okay.
So we got something for everybody.
Yeah. Now, what's this? Sky Target.
Sky Target.
I don't think I've ever seen that. Is that our original cabinet?
An original cabinet. There's just been a little ad hocking on the sides there.
I see.
But this was sitting in an arcade in Monrovia for the better part of a decade.
In where?
An arcade in Monrovia that shut down.
Okay.
So we brought it back over here.
Wow, I never seen that. That's pretty cool.
Yeah.
And that $800 seems really reasonable for that. Yeah. And you got San Francisco Rush and California Extreme. You got a Donkey Kong Jr. with Super Mario
this
Brothers in it.
Super Mario with a DK bezel at the moment.
Uh huh.
This is actually going out in a rental tonight to Funny or Die.
Oh, it is.
For the Funny or Die.
Oh, to Funny or Die.
Yeah.
Oh, that's cool. Nice. Street Fighter 2 and like a Dynamo cabinet. Now this cabinet, what did that used to be? What is that cabinet? That's familiar to me. Do you know?
All I know is it looks like it was just a basement.
Like a generic cabinet?
Yeah, some guy made a bunch of generics. So
oh, really?
Very awkward looking.
Yeah, it is totally different. It seems familiar, though. I don't know why.
Very easy to deliver, though.
Is it? All right, so then you got some gun games. Crisis Zone. Everyone likes that, yeah?
Just mostly our drivers.
Most of your drivers. Okay, Spy Hunter Cockpit. Spy Hunter's great, classic. This game here, Motocross Go. It's a Namco game. Hydro Thunder, Championship Racing Fury, Cruisin' USA, Cruisin' USA, Cruisin' World, Off-Road Thunder. You've got the topper up there for Cruisin'. Arm Champs 2. Oh, we saw this game at Galloping Ghost. That game's funny. Super Hang-On. That's like
Super
the...
Super Hang-On is going to need a new chassis before it gets out.
Silent Scope. I've always loved this game. I think it's so cool. You look through there, there's like a little video screen. Original Dig Dug. I love. Okay, cool. I love Dig Dug. Phoenix, $1,200. And that's the 19-inch monitor version. Here's a Junior that was converted to Mario Brothers.
Yeah, that's a multi right now.
What, this one is?
Yeah. The flat, man.
Okay. What is this game? Never Fab Tag Blood Brothers. Never heard of that.
I think we have two of them. We have another one that someone put in a Tron cabinet.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Wow, that's kind of cool. Looks like it was in a Century cabinet.
A lot of people on Saturdays love playing this. So.
Yeah, and it's like a two-player simultaneous game.
Yeah, just shoot
it. It kind of looks like that 1972 game on, like the way the controls are. You're aiming Cabal. A little crosshair. And Cabal and...
Yeah, those are great games.
Yeah. Missile Command, dedicated to Galaga. This is a multi-game, I take it?
Yeah, this is Xevious, Mappy, and Galaga.
Okay. Wait, it has three games in it?
Three games in it.
Really? What kind of board is it? Oh, is that's a Namco board, right?
Correct.
Yeah, okay.
Black Widow, Journey, and Tron waiting on a board.
So Journey, wow, man.
Yeah. Journey needs to be shot.
Does it?
Yes.
It's all original, though, huh?
Yep.
Boy, that blue color is a lot different than mine. I just restored a Journey, and I tried matching the paint. I don't think I got it 100%, and it looks good, but it's a little lighter than this. But this looks great. This coin door is somewhat...
I don't think you should be hard on yourself.
So the Journey works?
No, it needs to be shot.
Okay. Oh, it does.
Tron's ready to roll. We're just waiting on the board.
Okay. That's a nice looking Journey. I mean, what's your price on that? Like, if you, someone came in here and said they want to buy it.
This will be a Gene fully restored.
Oh, it will.
Vintage arcade price.
Oh, I see. Okay. I see. So the stuff in Gene's classic vintage arcade superstore, he restores that stuff and then sells it.
Right.
And the stuff here is as is. Get
as
it out of here.
Doesn't mean we won't do a fully restore.
Yeah, yeah.
But we are
for the most part.
As the outlet store.
I see. Gotcha. Yeah. In a crisis zone, Namco.
Crisis zone.
That's a cool cabinet.
New pedal on it recently.
Wow. That's a neat cabinet.
Yeah. A little more easy to manage.
Yeah. World-class bowling tubing. I love tubing, man. I actually kind of miss mine. It's got the waterfall marquee.
Yeah, it's a cool marquee.
Yeah, it's totally cool. It just reminds me of the old beer signs, you know? Because,
right.
You know, I'm from Illinois. I used to go up to Wisconsin, and my grandpa had, like, the Hams beer sign and stuff with the waterfall.
Yep.
It just reminds me of being a kid.
So we're toying with the idea of turning this world-class bowling into a Simpsons bowling.
Oh, okay. That's a good idea.
Has a little more appeal.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, Gene was telling me that, like, Simpsons and Turtles was, like, the number one games.
A lot of Turtles have been going out.
Really?
A lot.
Wow.
In fact, I don't even have one to show you right now.
Is that right? Dedicated Mappy, that's nice.
Yep.
Lethal Enforcers, Mortal Kombat.
In a
Konami cabinet.
So that obviously...
That could become a Turtles.
Be a Turtles.
Yes. Gorf, a Star Trek Void. This game's cool.
Yep.
It's a gun game, like a cockpit gun game. A friend of mine had one of those, and he was trying to get rid of it. He could not get rid of it at all.
Feel his pain.
I know. And he was like, come on, just get it out of here.
I actually had some bad friend yesterday who might take it.
Oh, really?
Yeah, we'll see.
Oh, Willow. Dude, this is a cool game. I like Willow. That's a cool Capcom game. You guys remember the movie Willow with the little guy? He's on a Ricky Gervais show now, right? Isn't he?
I think so. Yeah, is he on
Derek?
What?
I think he's on Derek, isn't he?
Yeah, I think so.
Yeah. Well, life's too short.
Yeah, life's too short.
There you go.
So, Sunset Riders, what is this cabinet? This is crazy. Do you know what the origin of that is?
We have one other like that. I have no idea. I think someone just...
Did they cut down a big cabinet?
I don't know. I think they just made the cabinet just so that it could be in like a place for little kids to play.
Right. It's kind of...
We have another one that's not the exact
I kind of like it for some reason.
Yeah,
it's almost like a sit-down...
It's like a mini Konami.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
So here's the Simpsons. That's a big cabinet. What cabinet was that?
Yeah. We don't know.
Story goes that company that made that cabinet is no longer in business.
Is that right? That thing is big.
Yeah.
All right, so here's a Neo Geo. This is some kind of conversion. Sprint 2, I've got one of these in my garage.
They're excellent. I mean, it's a,
Yeah, I've got one. I can't figure out what's wrong with the monitor, though. It keeps, there's a resistor that keeps glowing on it.
Right? It's like one for one play. Like,
yeah.
You play it, it drives real nice.
Yeah, yeah.
It's a 1977.
Yep, yep. Yeah, it's a cool game. All right, so then you guys got some... This is kind of the storage area back here, right?
This is what I like to call the arcade graveyard.
The arcade graveyard. So let's kind of take a look here. So you can see lots of stuff.
So
wow.
Here, left,
what's the... Oh,
combat.
Dude, those are cool, man. Those are... I used to have the Mario Brothers pinball, the
okay.
small one.
Yeah.
It kind of reminds me of this a little bit, but not quite. Boy, those are kind of neat, man. Are these redemption games?
Yep.
Wow, I've never seen them.
Yeah.
Yeah, then is that a multi monitor one?
Monitor.
Yeah, I saw Ninja Warriors at Galloping Ghost. F-15 Strike Eagle.
So you could look inside of it.
Yeah, so Ninja Warriors is just kind of like Darius. It has three monitors. Actually, is it two monitors or three?
Three.
Three,
yeah. And then the images all overlap each other, so
yeah,
it looks like one big image,
way.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's like optical illusion. I don't know what's going on here. So there's two monitors behind this glass,
yeah,
right?
A monitor here.
Yeah, and then there's one down here, and then one here.
And then that's this
and then
one
they,
overlaps the other
right,
two.
Right, right. Yeah, like X-Men does, and the six-player X-Men does that, and then Darius does. That is cool.
It's deceiving, because it looks like a little monitor in a giant cabinet.
Right, right, exactly.
Then you turn it on, and it's awesome.
All right, so we got some conversion stuff here. Daytona USA, Cruisin'.
Super GT Twins that we're going to set up shortly.
Nice, Virtual Cops. Road Runners. Here's a nice. That's actually not. Oh no, actually that thing is. That thing is hosed. Oh, Super Hang On. Oh, that's cool.
It's a lot of work.
Yeah, it does. So does this man. Look at that.
Yeah.
Beast Brothers, House of Dead, Rally X. There's an Omega Race. Oh, that Targ. What's that? That's cool. Target's kind of cool, man. There's a Mega Race, Asteroids is a Gauntlet conversion, air hockey table, Road Blasters. There's a Missile Command back there.
I think we have two more Missile Commands.
Oh, you do?
Yeah.
Here's another one of those short cabinets.
Yeah.
That's a lot of crazy stuff in here. NBA Showtime, Fury, Dark Silhouette. This is a some kind of former Robotron or something. Die Hard. Here's an old Taito cabinet. We've got Bubble Bobble in it. Now this here, this used to be like a Domino Man or a six-pack cabinet.
You got a Trog all the way back there.
Oh, you do? Here's a nice Stargate. That's not bad.
You see that spot over there?
That's 7-Up game?
Oh, oh.
I think there's like 20 of those in there.
No kidding.
Yeah, really, really, really.
So is this the, like a cabinet that they made out of the factory just like that?
Yeah.
Wow, it's like a dynamo type cabinet, right?
Yeah.
Is this game any good?
Yeah.
Have you played it?
It's like kind of weird backgammon. Your
answer was oh, really?
Yeah, I mean, it's weird. It's like this weird board thing.
Oh, it's not like a platformer or something? Wasn't the Spot game on the NES like a platformer?
I don't know. The graphics are really good, actually.
Yeah, definitely so all we're waiting on is the new monitor for that, and that'll be out there.
Wow, that's pretty neat.
Yeah.
Here's a dedicated versus cabinet. What's
this is Skate Kids, actually.
Oh, that's Skate Kid?
Yeah.
Oh, you got a marquee for it?
Yeah.
Dude, where did you get that?
Just found it.
Really? Wait.
We'll be producing those marquees shortly, actually.
Oh, dude, that's cool, man.
Yeah, we do a lot of art reproduction here.
Oh, you do?
So we back right to Plexi, so you can get marquees right to Plexi. We're doing Neo Geo repros.
Oh, you are?
The whole thing.
So I'm actually really curious about this, because I put the Skate Kid ROMs in mine, because 2Bits did that, right, originally?
I think so.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So is this marquee art from back in the day?
That's someone else's reproduction.
It is, but yeah. This originally, though, was a marquee that they released back in the day? Or
that I don't know. That one is definitely a reproduction, though. It's on a real fine.
Wow, that's neat. If you guys go back to my videos, you can see I did a video of versus Skate Kid, and it's kind of a weird little hack for Super Mario Brothers. That's really interesting. I've never seen a marquee for it.
Fun.
Cool board. Yeah, it is. Bagman.
Yep,
it's a conversion centipede.
Reproduction
yeah.
Art.
Okay.
So this is going out today.
Here's a nice Berserk. Not too bad. Defender, Rampage, and these guys here are fixing stuff.
These guys are back here working. This World Tour.
Oh, nice.
And this is going to become a main.
Oh, it is. This is going to be a main cabinet. So you guys do a lot with that too, huh?
Yeah.
What kind of front end would you put on it? Like Mala or?
What kind of what? I'm sorry.
The front end, like the menu interface.
Oh, it's Hyperspin.
Hyperspin. Okay, yeah. Cool. Nice. And so what's over here? Asteroids, System 1. Oh, that's a Death Race? Oh, man. What are you guys going to do with that? Nothing yet?
Future project.
Yeah.
And if we find a couple of pieces of art in Gene's shop, then
yeah.
Then we'll turn back into something.
Yep. Are the boards in there and stuff? You can see some of the artwork on the side.
The boards are
side art.
Yeah. It's a really cool game. I played the one at Fun Spot. It's a crazy game. It was very controversial, you know.
Yeah.
This is an old game too.
Yeah, it's an old Exidy game, and you're running over zombies, but people thought it was like people, and it was kind of like a banned video game. That's okay. You can leave it.
Okay. Yeah, I just wanted to.
Go watch my Fun Spot video. You can see the game in action. Super Sprint. What's back there? Oh, Kicks. Yeah. I miss my Kicks. Stargate.
So this is the Rampage World Tour. We did a custom control panel.
Okay.
This weird trapezoid.
Yeah.
Setup.
It's another interesting cabinet.
Turn it on.
Let's keep going. Let's go over here.
Tempest right there.
Yep. So okay. So if someone came here and said, "Hey, I want to buy this as is, where it is," what would you sell that for?
Well, I wouldn't sell it as is right now because there's no chassis, there's no board.
Oh, really?
So this would be a full restore.
I see. Okay. I'm just trying to get an idea, like you know, sure. what you sell this stuff for, you know?
I mean, we basically have games.
Oh, wow.
800 to 1500 as is.
I see.
And then the full restores are the prices that Vintage Arcade has.
Bank Panic. That's cool. Never seen that artwork before, because that's usually like in a Bally Midway cabinet, right? Interesting. Couple of Sega Carnivals. I really like this game. And that Frogger style cabinet, those usually don't hold up very well.
As you can tell.
Yeah, I know. Yeah, those particle board cabinets are just really tough to find in a nice condition. Asteroids Deluxe. Oh, this is cool. Milestar Mach 3 laser disc game. That's super cool.
We have a few laser games here.
Yeah. So this doesn't work, right? Or does it? Yeah.
None of our lasers are running at the moment.
Okay.
And then this is actually...
Whoa, what is this?
This is Police Trainer 2.
Okay.
But this has got the art from Voyager.
Oh, really? Oh, for the Star Trek game?
Yeah.
Oh, interesting.
So one day we'll do something without that.
And Midway, Fury...
You're more than welcome to go back here.
Yeah, we... Sure, let's see...
We're driving.
Oh, this is kind of cool.
Yeah. We started rebuilding this panel because the corners were bent. And then
I don't think I've ever seen this, so this must be original, right? Obviously, it's cut like the Batman logo. Yeah.
It's not a fun game.
It's not?
Obnoxiously loud.
So that's the Batman Forever game, Cruising USA. Here's a Gyrus that was converted to a Taito Twin Eagle. Iron Man. Oh, here's a nice Atari black and white football game. Another Sprint 2. Let's see what else.
Find your way back to our Neo Geo family.
Oh, nice. So what is this?
Right here.
This is kind of cool. What is this game? Some kind of old Midway black and white game?
This?
Yeah. Which game is this?
No, it's a good question. I can't remember them all.
Is that a jam game?
No, this one isn't.
It's pretty cool. I don't recognize it. I like the artwork on it though.
I'm here every day and I hardly recognize it.
Really?
Well, 300 games.
Yeah. So let's see.
There's a Ring King back there.
Battle Zone. What's that gray cabinet? Oh, there's a Ring King, yeah.
That is a ticket redemption game.
It's a ticket game?
Yes.
Okay. Ski Champ, let's see.
Or something, maybe?
Okay. So here's a Star Wars trilogy.
We've got a Twin 2 back there.
Here's another one of those Blood Brothers. And you got a bunch of Neo Geos. This game, Gridiron Fight? That's cool. Is this an original cabinet?
I believe it is.
Yeah.
Wow, that's kind of cool. So it's a football game, but more modern than the Atari black and white one, obviously. That's kind of neat. Running Gun. Hungry Dragon, is that like a redemption game?
Yeah, there's a few ticker engines back there.
Okay.
There's a Bumblebee one over there.
There's a Bumblebee, yeah. You guys definitely got some neat stuff here. This is a pole position cockpit, I think. Yeah. Well, cool. Belt stuck. All right, guys. Well, is that it? Anything else you want to show me? Or
there's a Trog up there.
Oh, there's a Trog? Oh, really? I like that game. Where is it? Oh, there it is. Oh, yeah, yeah. That's a cool game. I've been seeing a lot of those lately, but it's still a pretty rare game, right? Came out pretty late.
I think that has an X-Men control panel on it.
Oh, does it? Yeah, it says mutant power or whatever on it.
See this flicker bar?
Oh, that
art's on it's awesome.
That is cool.
The rest of it's under this one.
Like W.C. Fields and
Laurel
Hardy and a bunch of like movie stars like Frankenstein and stuff. That's
cool. That's a really nice condition too.
Yeah, it is. I've never seen that one before. That's neat. So this is the cabinet right here below it?
Yeah, under this other
condition. Oh, I see, okay.
And then we've got another, six or eight games coming this afternoon.
Oh, you do?
Yeah.
All right, actually, before we go, we got to play Willow. I don't know why I want to play this. I love this. Did you like this movie? Yeah, oh, you're not here. Am I talking to you?
It was a great movie. it was a good movie.
It was. What about the baby Willow? Willow the baby. Was that in the movie?
I think it was.
How do we coin this up? You got
no
a quarter?
Refunds, dude. Oh, is it,
it's locked.
Where's the... Oh, okay, sorry.
I don't have a quarter.
God forbid you actually pay to play one of these games.
A super...
Well, that's not bad.
That board's pretty pricey, isn't it, usually?
It's like 400.
Is it? All right, here we go. All right, so we have a little overworld map. Is that Willow? One young man to save a baby saint. Yeah, so there's a baby. What about the baby, Willow? Will, be careful. All right. Dude, Capcom did this kind of stuff so well back then, didn't they?
Yeah.
These platformers, like even like the Mickey Mouse one and DuckTales and... on the PC-10, I really like that Chippendale Rescue Rangers. Remember that game?
Yeah. You go with the buttons?
I guess you can't jump in the water. This jump button's not working. This would be a great game to play in Maine one day. Just sit down and try to finish it. Can I go in there? Who's that guy? Oh, they even have like a little shop in here? How cool is that? May it help you? Yeah, that's pretty cool. All right, so we level up our battle sword. Attack power increases. I only have 300 gold. Should we save it for the next store?
Can you point up and add more gold?
I don't know. Now how much gold? I have 517 gold. I see, so these guys are all dropping gold coins, and we're saving them up to buy better gear.
So it's Mario, but you actually can buy some gear.
So is this like a little mini boss? Ah, oh, fuck. Damn it. Got him. Oh shit, the bridge collapsed. Fuck!
Bridge collapsed and you were fine. And you
ran. Well, I was trying to get the gold. I don't know, I think this game's pretty cool, man.
This was made by Nightmare. Well, it wasn't a good movie.
No. How many lives do I have? Alright, here's the shop guy again. I got 1,000 gold now. I really want like a sword. Alright, so swords 2,000. Moonlight magic. Life is... Should I save up or get some? Let's get... Alright, I got moonlight magic. It says it's gonna rip apart the bad guys. We have run out of goods. All right.
You already bought. You can only buy one.
Oh, I have to exit. Was this game ever like on the NES or anything?
Not sure.
Archers. The baby you are looking for is in the hands of Bombord. You would be wise to something. Uh-oh. Giant rat wolf. Oh, how do I do that? There's only 2 buttons. Oh. I don't know, that's kind of cool. I dig it. Will is awesome. Should we play anything else before we go? All right, you know what? Actually, before we leave, I want to play this too. This actually looks pretty neat to me. I don't know why. I'm kind of a sucker for like airplane games.
Late 90s Sega, they did all
the Yeah, it's just, it's like very cool. It's like those jets, those are the Blue Angels, aren't they? Where were those guys? I used to build models all the time when I was a kid. I had those models. All right, let's play this.
All right, so this is called Sky Target Daredevil Air Force. All right, so we want to be the F-15, F-6, yeah, this one.
I used to have that model kit.
Are there pedals? No. All right, so it's just a flight stick. This is badass, man.
No throttle, all right?
No. This is it. Everything's in Japanese, by the way. Did you notice that?
That's real cool.
Yeah, it's totally cool, man.
$100
is a good deal.
Yeah.
This game's awesome. pistons or what? Can I do a barrel? Oh, shit.
It's a tanker. Oh, no. I thought it was a tanker.
I think it's a bomber.
Yeah, it's a bomber.
Oh shit, look at this thing.
Oh wow, it has bosses. That's pretty cool.
Dude, that thing is mammoth. It's kind of funny how like these jets are all grounded in reality and then right, this thing.
The enemies are like...
It's like something on a Con Air or something. Yeah. We gotta take down its engines, it's like... I'll say pushing this button.
What's your green button on the left? That's just the trigger button? What's mounted on the panel or... I think that's just your trigger.
Alright, we got rid of one engine.
It's kind of cool. It's a first, not a first person, it's a third person shooter, basically.
Yeah. Enemy escaped.
Oh, you only had 20% left, too.
This is the music.
Oh! I shouldn't be talking on your video, sorry.
Kill rate 50%.
You got enough of that?
Yeah, what were these, what was that jet called?
Hornet.
No, but this
isn't that the Hornet?
Working on it.
Oh.
Was that a Blue Angel working? No.
Oh, blue
it's
and
some,
yellow.
It's some kind of group, though.
Oh, really?
I don't know.
Like the Air Force version of the Blue Angels?
Something like that.
Blue Angels are Navy, right?
Yeah.
So you don't get men, you just get 100% level.
Oh, I
see. And then once that's depleted, you're done. You actually get quite a lot of playtime for one
there
credit.
There doesn't seem to be any incentive to use the cannons.
A stealth? Why are you attacking this American airline?
Hey, that's pretty cool. Alright guys, well if you're in the area, how far from LA are you? Half hour?
I say everyone's 40 minutes.
40 minutes?
40 minutes.
So if you're in the LA area, definitely check this place out. Is there like an address you can give them or?
21819 Plummer Street.
Okay.
Where you can go onto Yelp to Royce's Arcade Warehouse.
Okay.
And all the information you need is right there.
All right, awesome. All right, guys, well, that's it. Let's go back to the basement. Thanks, guys.
Thanks.
Bye. There you have it. That was Royce's Arcade Warehouse in Chatsworth. Is that what it was? Chatsworth, California. I'll put a link to his website and stuff. You can just Google Royce's Arcade Warehouse. But they were great guys. And yeah, I know. Look at this. We are going to fix it this week. This 720 is going to be done this week. It has to. I don't want to look at it like that anymore. I don't like it. I can't play it. I haven't been able to play this game in like 3 weeks. So we got to put those overlays on the control panel and the boombox and put that joystick back on there. But anyway, there you have it, guys. That was Royce's Arcade Warehouse in Chatsworth, California. And I have to say, it was pretty nice leaving the snowy weather here in New England and going to California. But... I am officially sick of traveling this year. I'm not going anywhere for a while.
we're going to be spending the next couple weeks down here in the basement, and I actually have some time off for the holidays. So I'm going to be doing a bunch of videos, I think, the rest of the year. And but I don't want to go anywhere, man. I'm seriously sick of being at airports and on planes. I know, poor John. But anyway, so why don't we do some viewer mails? I printed three of them. And by the way, I guess we're going to make this an official segment of this show. I don't see any reason why we can't do this every episode if you guys like it. And if you do like it, you got to send them to me. Send the questions to blkdog7@gmail.com. blkdog7@gmail.com. That's blackdog7@gmail.com. And the most important thing here is that in the subject line, you got to put viewer mail, please. In the subject line, viewer mail. That way I can find these easily in my email. So I printed out three, and I think three is about the right number to do. And I got a ton of them, and thanks, guys, for sending these. So the first one is from Bill McAvoy, and he says, "Hey, John, love the show. I just watched the walkthrough of Galloping Ghosts. I have two questions for viewer's mail. Question one." I'm drinking wine today. No Tito's. I might be taking a Tito's break. We'll see. But anyway, question one. Do you have an experience with the J-Rock multi-boards, Williams or Stern? Yes, I do. I actually used to have the J-Rock Williams multi-board, and I loved it. It was fantastic. This guy, J-Rock, does fantastic work, and I've also heard that the Stern, the Berserk / Frenzy board, is also equally as good. What's good about his boards, too, is that he runs the original CPU. So it's not technically emulation like in MAME, and it's very, very accurate. I think the sounds are sampled, but everything else is pretty much all original running on FPGA with the original CPU. And I had the Multi-Williams board, and I really, really dug it. I actually built a Multi-Williams cabinet. I'm pretty certain I've done a video on that. And the only reason I got rid of it, I actually had it in a Bubbles cabinet, because I bought a Bubbles that was converted to Combat Tribes, which is like a JAMA junk game. And actually, when I got it, I didn't even know it was a Bubbles. I just saw it on Craigslist for $50, and I said, hey, a working game for $50. It turned out it was Combat Tribes in a Bubbles cabinet. And then I'm like, well, hey, I should convert this to some kind of Williams game or back to a Bubbles. And then J-Rock released the Multi-Williams board. And so I built a Multi-Williams cabinet. The only downside about building a Multi-Williams cabinet is that you have to create a control panel that satisfies all the games. You know, because it's got Defender, Stargate, Robotron, Bubbles, Blaster, what else is on there? I think that's it. And all of those games have different control schemes. You know, Bubbles had like an optical joystick. You know, Stargate has a very specific control, you know, left, right on one side, and then like five buttons over here. And Robotron uses two joysticks. And you can see all the games use a very different scheme. And so they make these Multi-Williams control panels that basically have every possible controller configuration. What I didn't like about it is that, now the board itself is perfect. The emulation is spot on. But if you're gonna use, now the board you can set to boot into one game. So say you've got a Defender cabinet that's just hosed. It doesn't work, it's trashed. You're missing the harness, you're missing everything, and you wanna bring it back to life. The J-Rock board is actually a good way to do it, because you can get the J-Rock Multi-Williams board, wire the cabinet JAMA, install this modern, reliable board, and have it set to only run Defender. And then when the game turns on, it'll boot into Defender. You can't tell that it's not original. And that's what's good about those boards. But when you build the Multi-Williams, you gotta make these just hideous control panels, and I didn't like it. Because at the end of the day, I was only playing Robotron. And two joysticks, and my hands are hitting the buttons, and it wasn't ideal, because I really only liked Robotron. So what I did then was I traded my Multi-Williams to my buddy Jay for a dedicated Robotron, and now I'm happy. But if you don't have that option, or you want to build a Multi-Williams, if that sounds appealing, I recommend it, though. It's a great board. Same thing with the Stern Berserk / Frenzy board. Now, that board those two games use pretty much the same control scheme. So to have that board in a Berserk or a Frenzy, there's no like compromises because the control panel for either one is the same. So anyway, yes, to answer your question, I love it. Do you plan on attending the tournament at Fun Spot in 2015? Absolutely. I go every year. I will be there. And if you guys don't know what he's talking about, the American Classic Arcade Museum in Fun Spot has a tournament every year. Okay? And it's a great time. All the high score guys come from around the country to this. It's a big event. I like going to it just because it kind of forces me to play some of these obscure games. And a lot of times they do put obscure games in the tournament, which is great because you get exposed to a lot of stuff you wouldn't have otherwise played. And I really like the tournament. Now, I'm not good. I can't compete. But I just like to go for fun. And it's usually like kind of a buddy weekend and we get a cabin and drink a lot and stuff. But I highly recommend going there if you've never gone to that tournament. It's a lot of fun. And I wouldn't worry if you're good or not. It doesn't matter. Just go up there and enjoy yourself and play the games. All right, so let's see here. Next question from Justin Van Allen. It says, hey, John. First, I just want to say I have enjoyed watching your videos the past couple of years and also tuning into the podcast on Tuesday night. My question is, do you like any shooters? I don't see any in your basement. I haven't heard you talk about them. Have you ever had any? I think they are great for parties. Do you plan on getting any in the future? If so, what titles? Also, I would like your opinion on my favorite three shooters, which are Operation Wolf, Mechanized Attack, and Space Gun by Taito. Okay, you know, I actually get this question a lot. People want to know, John, you have no gun games. You need a gun game down here. And I agree with you. And I think in 2015, I'm going to get a gun game down here. Now, I did pick up a Hogan's Alley cabinet. It's in the garage. So technically, I have a gun game right now, but it's not working. I got to fix the guns. And I'm not really sure that's the gun game I want down here. I actually have two games in mind. Number one, Williams Turkey Shoot. You guys remember we went to Joe Majera's and we played that? Really cool game. It's like an 80s style Williams game with a gun. It shoots feathers. It's a quirky game. It's like it's got like these turkeys robbing banks and stuff and you gotta shoot them. I like it. So Williams Turkey Shoot is high on my list of shooters. And then the other game, which to me seems really fun, maybe more fun than Turkey Shoot, is Point Blank. Either Point Blank or Point Blank 2. It's a Namco shooter. It's fairly modern, but the cabinet is sick. I absolutely love the cabinet. The artwork is so bizarre. And it's almost like a WarioWare kind of... It's like a bunch of mini games that you play with the gun. And that's, I think, the one that might appeal to me the most, and that is Point Blank. So I've been on the lookout for a Point Blank or Point Blank 2. I don't want to spend a lot of money, though. I really don't, because I think those games can go for a lot of cash. I don't want to spend a ton of dough to get one, but I definitely want a dedicated one because the artwork is so cool. And I would take either Point Blank 1 or 2. I'm not sure. Point Blank 2 might be better. So I do want a shooter. I agree. And to answer your question, Operation Wolf. That was a game I loved when I was a kid. I loved Operation Wolf. It was so cool. It had like an Uzi and you could a grain launcher on the side. I like it. I like that game a lot. I don't think I would own it, though. I think it might get too repetitive. Because it's like a linear story, kind of on the rails shooter kind of thing. Now, the other two games, I have to admit, I don't think I've played. Mechanized Attack by SNK, 1989, and Space Gun by Taito. I feel like I've played Space Gun. You know what? I don't have an opinion on those other two games. Sorry, Justin. I'm not going to make something up. I've never played those, or if I have, I don't remember. I'm just not familiar with those. But Operation Wolf, I'm definitely familiar with, and I did enjoy it as a kid. My buddy Adam's got one. It's a neat game. I just think it gets a little old quick, just because it's so linear. All right, last question. And I had to read this because I've gotten about 30 of these messages. Like, maybe even more, okay? John, love the show. Here's a lighthearted question for you. Do you have plans to restore the Patriots table so that it stops wobbling? I'd hate to see your Tito's crash on the floor. Regards, DK Sean. P.S., what is your Donkey Kong high score? Okay. don't know what to tell you about this table. Everyone keeps commenting about how it's not level. I tried to level it. Let me show you. Look it. It's got these little leg levelers down here. I tried leveling it. I don't know what else to do here, right? It's got these little feet, right? And I unscrewed them and I leveled it off and it seems kind of level down here, right? Look it. It's level. You see that? It's not, the legs are not moving. The problem is this table has a high center of gravity, right? So the table is level. It's just that like this part is not tight on here or something. I don't know what to do, but look at, do you see how the legs are not moving when I shake the table? The problem is right here. So maybe I need to take this off and see if I can tighten this down. I don't know. It's really bothering you guys. I don't know what to tell you. I really don't. I honestly don't know what to say about the table, guys. It kind of is what it is. And some of you guys say you're going to stop watching my videos until I get it fixed. I don't know what to say about the table. Sean also says, P.S., what is your Donkey Kong high score? My Donkey Kong high score, I think, is around 274. I've never broken 300,000. It's actually bothering me. Because I played some Donkey Kong over the weekend. Or actually, I don't think I played. I think we were talking about it. And I want to get back to playing that. Because when I first started collecting, that was the first game I had. And I was playing Donkey Kong daily. Like, daily. And when I first got the game, my initial goal was to get to 100,000 points. Which is an absolute milestone in that game. If you can get to 100,000 points, you understand the game, okay? So I got to 100,000 points. And after that, it kind of plateaus a little bit. And then the next milestone was 200,000 points. And I got that. And then every now and then I'd have some random games. I get 220, 210, 230. And then my highest was 274. I've never broken 300,000. So that's my next milestone. And I think this winter I'm going to play more of that. I got to get back to Donkey Kong because I kind of did get away from it. Because, like, again, when I first started collecting all the time, Donkey Kong, Donkey Kong, Donkey Kong, Donkey Kong. And then more games showed up and I got distracted. I started playing Pole Position more. So I'm going to be going back to Donkey Kong this year because I'd like to break 300,000 this winter. I think that'd be fun. Maybe I'll tape them too. I got to warm up though. I'm a little rusty. I haven't played in a while. Actually, it's funny though. I always get high scores on games when I don't play them for a long time and then I come back to them. Like, it's true. Like, you know, if I play Donkey Kong over and over and over again, my scores start going down, actually. But if I take a break for a couple weeks and I come back cold, I'll get 200,000 points. So there's something about playing the game too much that it doesn't necessarily make you better if you're just playing so much in a row. That I think taking breaks is a good idea. So I've taken a big break, so maybe we'll get back to that. So anyway, that's it for this week's viewer mail. If you guys want to send these, send them to blkdog7@gmail.com. blkdog7@gmail.com. That's blackdog7@gmail.com. Important, very important. Please, 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 subject line, viewer mail. I won't find it otherwise. If you put anything else in there, if you want to get creative and say, John, this is viewer mail, here's my viewer's mail, fine, I'll find it. But you got to have these two words, viewer and mail, in the subject line, and then I'll find it. So anyway, that's it for this week's video. I'm planning on doing a midweek video probably around Wednesday. I think we're going to do 720. We might do a Mario, I want to do, for some reason, a versus Super Mario Bros. Gameplay video. So that's going to be coming this week. And then I think next weekend, we're going to go back to California. Because I filmed another video there. My buddy Kalen and his friends opened up an arcade club, right? And it's a private arcade in a warehouse. So they rented a space, and they all put their games in there. And it's actually really cool. And it seems to be a trend right now. So I went there and I filmed the place, and they had a lot of great restored games. And so we'll probably go in there next week. But during the week here, I want to do another video, maybe the 720 restore, or maybe the versus Super Mario Brothers. And anyway, I do release videos every Sunday and sometimes in between. If you want to keep up with the videos, if you like these games like I do, you got to click subscribe. So go ahead and click that. I do want to thank you guys for supporting me. I know I said I wasn't going to keep talking about this, but I have to at least thank the people that have given me donations, because there is a support button now on YouTube. It's a new feature of YouTube, and if you go on the homepage, on my YouTube page, youtube.com/blkdog7, or just search for John's Arcade, you'll see a support button. And you guys have been supporting me in the last week, sending donations, and I want to thank everyone that's done that. And I'm going to tell you, I'm going to use that money to buy a wireless mic. I don't have enough yet, but I'm going to use whatever money comes from that support button to make this channel better with equipment and cameras and parts and web hosting, whatever. It's going to be used to basically fund this world, mostly for like web hosting and you know, camera stuff and mics and all that. So the first thing I want to get is a wireless microphone. I think that's going to make my videos better. I think it's going to make me less tethered to this camera, you know? So especially when we're doing restore stuff, because having the cord like I do is a major hassle and it always gets tangled up. So anyway, enough of that. And then also my band, The Kill Screens, the album is on iTunes and Amazon and also on Spotify. It's called The Kill Screens. The band is called The Kill Screens. The album's called Science Fiction Movie. All the music in these videos is by me and my band. So if you like the music, get the album. And check out my two podcasts, Video Game Outsiders and Arcade Outsiders. VideoGameOutsiders.com, ArcadeOutsiders.com. We do those podcasts live every Tuesday, starting at 9 p.m. Eastern on AllGames.com. By the way, I'm tired right now. I don't know if I'm lacking the energy that I feel I am. Am I? I took a red eye home last night from California, and which means I left California at midnight, and I got home this morning at 8 a.m. And now I'm doing this video. And so I didn't sleep very well on the plane. I'm fatigued. And this wine is gonna make me sleep like a baby tonight. Cause I need to sleep. Cause I'm definitely overtired. So anyway, guys, thanks for subscribing to my channel. Leave comments, tell your friends and all that good stuff. I truly appreciate all the comments. And anyway, that's it for this Sunday's video. I'll see you guys in the middle of the week. Later, guys, and bye.